My name is Dewey Dunnington. I'm a PhD student at the Center for Water Resources Studies. And what I study is lake sediment and how that informs us about how lakes have changed over time. I got brought in looking at Halifax Water's drinking reservoirs. Many communities get their water from groundwater. But in Nova Scotia, it's a different story because so many of these communities are close to the coast and many large populations, it's hard to get enough groundwater. So the surface water reservoirs are really important to maintain water quality over time. And as we're trying to recreate that history, what we want is a representative sample of the different layers that have built up over time. You can't slice the lake in half and look at all of the layers that come. So instead, what you do is you take a little core, and it usually ends up being a tube about 5 or 10 centimeters across. And you get a representative tube of sediment from the lake. Every time you collect this little tube of sediment, it actually represents a lot of work. The lake that we looked at last week was Sandy Lake. So after we loaded all the stuff into the boat, we put the boat into the water, and then we motored off to the place that we were going to take the core. The equipment that you have to take out is that you have to get a coring mechanism. So the core usually sits on top of a little tube, you have a plastic tube, and then you have something that sits on top of that that is able to seal the top of that core tube. And so then when you pull the core tube out of the sediment, it's like putting your finger over a straw and taking a sample of milkshake out of a very thick milkshake. You're sort of sucking the sediment out. So what happens is you drop the core attached to the core tube over the side of the boat, and you lower it down until it's just above the bottom. And then you lightly let it drop and settle into the sediment. And then you have to send down a little messenger that triggers the thumb that goes over the straw, basically, and so it'll seal the top of the core tube.
So you send the messenger down. You feel like a chunk when you're on
And then you have to pull it up and get something in the bottom of the core tube before the milkshake or lake sediment falls out of the bottom. So we took a core at the deepest point, and we took a core at a slightly shallower point in the lake. We sealed the top and the bottom with bungs and duct tape, and then we sectioned them in the lab. There's a couple of ways to transform this tube of mud into something that we can actually analyze. And so typically what is done is something called extrusion. So we extrude the core and slice it into very thin sections that might represent anywhere from 5 to 10 to 20 years, depending on how quickly sediment builds up in that system. But we look for different clues about different things that might have happened in the lake. For example, things like titanium concentration and potassium concentration and iron concentration. And so I've been working with lake sediment in various respects for a long time, and I'm very interested in what the tool of looking at lake sediment has to say to things like engineering and water quality scientists.